Welcome to Yes Bitch TV, honey. Yes God, I'm here. I'm queer. I'm trying to be everywhere. Make sure you're liking, commenting, and subscribing to the channel. Hit that bell. That way you're updated every time Yes Bitch TV is bringing the good shit, honey. Yes God. So you know I got to bring y'all my motherfucking opinions. The review of the Chasing Dallas season one reunion, bitch. And before we get into the context of a lot of the conversations that took place amongst the cast, you know, we got to talk about the production setup and the reunion, and we got to talk about the fashions, bitch. Okay. So first off, the lighting was horrible. It should have been evenly distributed amongst the entire cast. It was mainly focused on the host. He's already light skinned than a motherfucker. Any more light on him, he would have looked invisible. Speaking of the host as well, he's following the teleprompter, very unprofessional. It appeared as if you did not do a rehearsal or a training beforehand, so it looked very unprofessional and very distracting as a viewer. It just kind of looked like you didn't know what you were doing. Even though you did control the conversations and the narratives in this whole discussion, but we'll get into that a little later. The microphones were... some were on high, some were on low. Maybe that was shady as fuck. Maybe that was just the technical difficulties that we have bared witness through the entire season of Chasing Dallas. Camera quality. It's 2018. Phones have some of the best motherfucking qualities in their cameras. So I don't know what kind of device you guys were using to record the reunion. But my God, it was a hot motherfucking mess, in my opinion. Now let's just get into the fashion. Well, the set. Let's get into the set first. It was really cute. Very Real Housewives with the whole royal theme. The gold and burgundy was a cute touch. Very Southern Belle. I live for it. And now let's talk about the fashions collectively. First of all, whatever happened to following a theme? I remember back in the day when Housewives first started and Love and Hip Hop and then first came out, there was a theme. I'm quite sure production used to send out emails about this is what we're going for. This is the Greek goddess theme, or we're going for that 1960s glam kind of theme, or, you know, follow. I think if the show follows a theme, it'll be easier to get these cast members to dress accordingly. And it's nothing to hire a Fashion Institute student that needs credits for their class. You guys are a production company, so you are a legitimate business where you can give credit to a fashion intern to come in and help style you guys for the free. If you utilize that to your advantage, then we will not have these fashion mishaps on these reunions, because you guys are dressing better in your confessionals and throughout the entire season and coming to the reunion dressed like motherfucking bullshit. And that goes for almost every reunion that I've seen, even with Chasing Atlanta season one and two. It was the same thing. Very lackluster fashions in the reunion. Premier, he looked like he ate a Smurf and shitted that bitch out, and glitter just fell on the fucking children. He gave that designer a lot of props, and in the comment section, people were reading that bitch for filth, and I really feel bad for him. I feel like the outfit was undone. It wasn't a finished product. And I think just because of the platform that he was going to be on, you just kind of rushed the whole situation altogether. The outfit was horrible. It was really horrible. And Premier, you dressed pretty cute throughout the entire season, except for that Sister Mary Clarence cloak, that Lord Voldemort cloak you were wearing in that one confessional, girl. But I would have rather seen that on the reunion than this blue glitter shit that you were wearing. Looks like first graders were making it in their art class, but okay, whatever. B King was dressed like he just went out to the bar real quick with a couple homeboys, to go scout for a third person for his marriage. We'll get into that later, y'all. King Kane, he was dressed pretty okay, I guess. When he took that jacket off, I was like, oh, more blue. More blue. I don't know what's up with the blue. It's burgundy and gold in the background, y'all. It's burgundy, gold, and like this red accents. Y'all were wearing blue, for crying out loud. Premier, King Kane and Markel were all wearing blue. And what the fuck? Reese G was dressed like the normal corporate career bitch that he is. Aubrey was dressed like he was P. Diddy back in the 90s with, what was he wearing, Versace or Gucci or whatever that was. It just seemed like all in shoulda, coulda, woulda was dressed in every label known to man. And I'm just saying, like, as gay people, like, wow, like, you guys claim to be in these style fields and fashion and beauty, and all of y'all are just coming to the stage dressed like pure shit. I just don't understand it. You could easily go to someone's thrift store, girl, or Walmart and put together a better outfit than what you girls, instead of, you're focused on labels all the time instead of actual fashion. And I believe that is the problem. I feel like I walked into a bad 1960s theme party because all y'all's outfits collectively were just fucking trash. I guess let's move on from that. And, you know, this whole reunion was basically a catch-up of the final episode between Reese G and Daddy Charles going back and forth in their motherfucking arguments about he say, she say, about scammers and all this other shit. Again, like I said in my last review, we'll never really know the entire truth. Reese G did kind of admit that a lot of the things that were manipulated in this season was by him to create entertainment for the viewing public. I can appreciate that level of honesty, but what that does is when you make a big broad statement like that, when people are combating the issues from the season, it kind of makes it, we have no choice but to believe those people like Charles in this situation, because you claim to have amped things up for entertainment purposes. So now we don't really know everything that comes out of your mouth. Is that truth? You know what I'm saying? So we have no choice but to question the validity of what it is that you're telling us about certain cast members and the situations surrounding the bigger problems. And again, we don't have true clarity on a lot of these issues because, again, you did admit as well that a lot of these problems derived off camera and some of the issues were brought on camera. So it leaves the viewing audience like, well, what the fuck is really going on here? Basically, the same thing goes for all the web series that I review. That's the basic consensus, is a lot of us don't know what's going on. We can't keep up because you're bringing things onto the show that happen off the show, and then you're only bringing us half of the situation and not all of it. So it makes it kind of hard to keep up, or it actually makes it more difficult for us to take sides because we don't really know the true nature of these motherfucking discussions. Let's see. Markel got into it with B. King about B. King's personal choice to have an open marriage. And let me be honest with you, that is B. King's personal right as a human being. It is not your motherfucking business to place any kind of judgment on how people decide to live their lives. What works for him may not work for you, Markel. So you need to understand that, because it seemed like you took that very personally. And you're talking about the foundation that of God, and that love is under God, and we take these vows and everything. Girl, that's just a traditional way of doing things. That's just how it's always been done. So we in turn kind of follow that societal norm, but doesn't necessarily mean that we have to follow the motherfucking details and the rules, bitch, of what that says. Okay. So again, Markel, it may not work for you, but that works for him. He's secure in himself and his marriage to have that kind of fun, and let him do him, girl. Okay. We talked a little bit about, what else did we talk about? There really wasn't much to discuss because Markel didn't have much to say other than going back and forth with B. King about his personal relationships. Premier didn't really have that much to say as well. His outfit said it for him. Reese G, the basic, thing with him was him and Daddy Charles going at it with each other. Shoulda, coulda, woulda, and Charles were able to finally come together and have some kind of resolution to their conflict. Apparently, woulda overstepped, and because Charles, I guess, was the face of the company at the time, it was easier to pass blame on him regarding the whole money and the investment situation. So woulda was able to apologize and say, look here, just because you were the face of the situation, that's when I decided to go ahead and put the blame on you, but I apologize for that. You didn't deserve that, and you know, let's squash the beef. So that was pretty good to see. They gave each other a handshake and a hug. Oh yeah, Daddy Charles was dressed like 1970s John Travolta, bitch. Yes, God. I'm not a big fan of tuxedo pants, but you know, the fucking blazer was really cute, and I just lived for his haircut. Everything was really cute on him. what else? And apparently Daddy Charles no longer works with this company. He claims it was a mutual separation. But at the end of the day, the timing couldn't be more suspect. Let's be honest here, because, apparently you're not the only one. The tea is that this company has had other complaints against them about money situations and people not getting paid their shit back. So you're saying that you separated from the company and it was amicable, but at the end of the motherfucking day, why did you really leave? And especially if shoulda, coulda, woulda is not the only person complaining that these people have not produced the funds as promised. So I hate that we're taking on the stereotype that gay owner operated companies cannot be trusted because they have a scamming nature. Okay, bitch. I hate that, especially when we're trying to do things collectively in our community and we put our names and our faces and our brands to market and showcase what we can do for the community. But when you got people investing and you're having this history of not providing the services or paying back people their money, you get this rap. And can you be motherfucking upset if people don't no longer want to do business with your ass? So I could understand and see why shoulda, coulda, woulda was upset about his coins. I don't give a fuck if it was $2 or $3 I invested. If there's a promise to pay, there's a promise to pay. And if you don't uphold that motherfucking promise to pay, then bitch, hopefully we have this in a contract and in writing so I can sue your motherfucking ass for damages. Okay. There is really nothing else to discuss about this motherfucking reunion like that. I mean, all it was, there was no conflict resolution. There was nothing clarified. We're basically stuck in limbo on a lot of the shit that took place. Most of the cast, you could tell, just did not want to be there. Tony Price was not in attendance. He made a letter and sent a letter via Charles that he read for everybody. It was a very well-read letter, very well-written letter. I'll put the link in the description of the video so you guys can see the letter for yourself. But basically, it was just describing his experience on the Chasing Dallas platform. He appreciates the opportunity, but he did feel like he was exploited. His story was exploited for personal gain, just for entertainment for the show. And he felt like he was discarded off of things that had no real merit. That's his story. Let him tell it. I do kind of believe Tony in a way. I do feel like once I spilt my personal deep, dark secrets, all of a sudden I get a exit letter telling me that I'm no longer on the show. So I would, if I feel him, I would feel some type of way. Reese G explained that there will be a season 2, but not sure if the same cast that we see on season 1 will be present in that following season. Chasing Atlanta will be back next year. Hopefully that has a new cast as well. Kind of over the old cast, to be honest. I don't think in order to move forward with these web series, we need people who are going to take it seriously. We need good direction. We need better quality. And, you know, it's no shade to these motherfucking production shows. But at the end of the day, you guys got to take our advice, because if you have 1 million people saying the same motherfucking thing and having the same concerns and the questions and suggestions, then hopefully you're taking the motherfucking criticism well. I know some production on other web series don't take that kind of criticism that well. Okay. But hopefully you guys do, because we want to see you do well. A view is a view, but more negative views just hints the fact that there needs to be something changed within the production and whatever it is that you guys are trying to bring to the motherfucking table. Anything else? No, as a whole, Chasing Dallas season 1 was pretty good. It highlighted a lot of the business and the networking that we need to see and that fails in these web series. But Chasing Dallas and the fucking reunion was very motherfucking classy. Yes, honey, the reunion was very classy. There was there was arguments, but there was no fighting. And I think, again, that's due to close set. Thank God for that. And due to the fact that these young guys have something going for themselves business wise. They have their own brands. Their foot is already in the door in their chosen dream or career or profession. So these men have something to lose. So they're not going to be on here running amok, acting crazy, being drunk as fuck. And I appreciate that, too. Nobody was drunk. Nobody was slurring words. Nobody was being irate and disrespectful. It was a wonderful reunion, especially in regards to just the respect factor amongst the cast. And we can all agree to disagree, but we don't have to be disrespectful. And again, that is what separates this particular franchise from the rest of the web series. And that is something positive. We do need a little tea. We do need a little entertainment. But at the end of the day, we don't want that to overshadow the ultimate goal of the show. So big ups to Chase in Dallas. I'm very interested to see what season two will bring. I think Risa G's doing a great job. I think there's a lot of pressure on him. And it's not fair to judge every single and nitpick everything, even though I kind of did through this whole video. But I only do those things because I know what we as the gay community are capable of doing. And that's all I really have. I hope you guys enjoyed the season. Let me know what you thought. Again, I will put the description of the reunion in the, I will put the link in the you know what the fuck I mean. I'll put the motherfucker, I'm tired, bitch. I will put the link in the description for the reunion if you have not had a chance to catch up on it. It was supposed to be a two-part, but they decided to go ahead and combine it into one video. Thank God, because I would have been kind of pissed off seeing the second part and waiting all that time for a very lackluster reunion. But overall, I give props. They're doing something in the community. They're trying to highlight our community when nobody else on the mainstream media is trying to do that. So amen for us, by us. I'm with that bullshit. You guys have a blessed day. And again, let me know what y'all think. Have a blessed one. Bye.